Morning everyone. So in the previous lecture we have started with the types of construction scheduling. So under that we have mainly three types. So in that first one is already completed, that is bar chart or Gantt chart. So what we did in this type, so we have taken a particular project and we have divided that project into a number of activities. By knowing their relation, that is sequence of activities, we have drawn a structure. So which resembles like a bar. So this is about the bar chart. So in the same way we need to create a network for the analysis purpose for a particular project. So that is nothing but project network analysis. So this is the second type for the construction scheduling. So how to create a network or how to create a diagram for this type and how to analyze, we'll see further. So this is second one, that is project network analysis. So this is the second type in construction scheduling. So what happens here, the term project network analysis is a generic term that covers all the network techniques used for planning, scheduling and controlling of project. So what it means, so if you want to plan, schedule and control a particular project, then this network analysis method plays a very important role. By using this method you can easily draw a network diagram and you can easily analyze those network diagram in order to achieve the project mission or vision effectively. So here the three such commonly used techniques under project network analysis are, one is critical path method, CPM or critical path method, and the second one is PERT, which means program evaluation and review technique, and the third one is PDM, that is precedence diagramming method. So these are the commonly used techniques in order to draw a network diagram for a particular project and in order to analyze those network diagram to get the objectives of the project. So what do you mean by CPM? So what do you mean by PERT and what do you mean by PDM? We'll see further. You can see the flowchart, that is program networking techniques. So commonly used techniques are, that is activity on arrow, that is AOA technique, and the second technique is activity on nodes, that is AON technique. So what do you mean by activity on arrow or activity on nodes? We'll see further. So under this category we have, that is AOA category, two main methods, that is CPM and PERT. So these are the two important methods for syllabus. So generally we don't have PDM and GERT technique for the syllabus. So these are the two main techniques we are learning as per the syllabus. So under the category of activity on arrow, so we have mainly two types, that is CPM, critical path method, and the second one is PERT, that is program evaluation and review technique. So what then comes, what do you mean by CPM and what do you mean by PERT? By using this technique, how to draw a network diagram? So those we'll see further. So under the category of activity and arrow techniques, so as I told, there are two main methods, that is CPM and PERT. So we'll start with the CPM, that is first technique, critical path method. So critical path method network analysis fundamentals. So what do you mean by critical path method? So how to draw a network for CPM method and how to analyze? So what are the fundamentals we require to draw a network diagram? We'll see here. So here a network shows a sequence and interdependence of an activities of a project and which is shown in a diagrammatic form by using some standards. So this is about network. So network is nothing but which is represented in a diagrammatic format. How to represent? By using sequence of activities and also by using some standard symbols. So by using those symbols along with the activities, that is sequence of activities, we can easily frame or create a network diagram so that it will be very easy for analysis purpose. So that is nothing but network analysis. So What are the fundamentals we require? So we'll see one by one. So under the fundamentals category, that is, we require some tools along with the activities so that we can easily create a diagrammatic form or structure. So as we did in the bar chart or Gantt chart. So what are those tools? We'll see. That is, first tool is activity. So as I told, activities plays a very important role. So without the activity, we can't complete the project. So without the completion of activity, the project can't be completed. So activity is very important. So for framing a structure or diagram, we require activity. So a project can be broken down into various activities that are necessary for its completion. An activity is an identifiable, quantifiable, measurable, costable, and discrete lowest level element of work which must be performed during the course of a project in order to achieve the project mission. So as I told in the earlier class also, activity means by using WBS structure, that is work breakdown structure, we are creating a number of activities in a project. So until each particular person can handle a particular work effectively, so that is nothing but activity. So that activity must be identifiable, so I can easily identify that particular activity. Quantifiable, it should be some quantifiable and measurable, costable and discrete lowest level work. So if these includes in a particular work, so then it is called as an activity. So for example, you can see here, acquiring of land. So for any construction purpose, we require land. So acquiring of land is one particular activity in a project. Fixing steel, so is another activity. So under a particular project, you will get n number of activities. So in that, fixing of steel is one activity. Collecting materials is another activity. Building a wall is another activity, etc. So this is very important. So not only these four are the activities. So in a project, there will be a number of activities. So these are just an example. So you can see, pouring of concrete, curing of concrete, excavation. So likewise, you will get n number of activities. So those are called as activities. So that activity we require in order to draw a network diagram for the analysis purpose. So this is this is about activity, which is basic fundamental to draw the network diagram. So this is first one, activity. So how to use that activity? So and what are the standards or symbols used for a particular activity? We'll see here. So the activities are represented by arrows in the forward direction. So whatever the activity which are coming under a particular project, so that will be represented in a arrow format, arrow in the forward direction. So like you see here, you can see here. So this is one particular activity, or you can show a particular activity like a arrow which is in a forward direction. You can't draw activity in the reverse direction. So this is very wrong. So if you draw an arrow with the forward direction, that resembles a particular activity. So this is very important. So this is very important because it will help in drawing the network diagram. So if I draw one arrow in the which is moving in the forward direction, that resembles a particular activity is moving. So next, there is no hard and fast rule, that is, I should draw the arrow in the forward direction like this only. So you can draw in n number of ways, as you can see here. First type, that is a straight arrow, and the second type, so this is somehow inclined like this. So this is another type of way to draw the network diagram. So likewise, you can draw in any ways, but it should be moving in the forward direction with some head of the arrow. So if this is the symbol which indicates a particular activity in a project. So next comes the, so you can see here note, that is, the description of an activity is written above the arrow and its duration in the middle below. So what it means? if I want to resemble or if I want to draw a particular activity, so then what I will do? So I will just draw the arrow in the forward direction with some head here. So what it means, the tail end indicates the start of an activity. Tail end means this one, starting point. So this indicates start of a particular activity. If you take excavation activity, so excavation will start here, and the other end, or you can see head of the arrow, indicates the completion of that excavation activity. So this is the activity resembles, or you can show in a forward direction like this. So you can see here, for example, excavation is there. So this tail end indicates start of an activity or excavation, and this arrowhead indicates the completion of that particular excavation activity. So I have written that description of that particular activity above the arrowhead. So if I write anything above the arrowhead, like this excavation or curing, so that I should write above the arrow. If anything is writing above the arrow, means that is nothing but description of that particular activity. So what it indicates, so what work is going on, so that will be written on the above the arrow. So that is excavation. So as you can see here, so whatever the numbers I am writing below the arrow, so that is 2 units. You can see here, 2 units means it may be 2 hour or 2 days, anything it may be. So 2 units. So anything if I write below the arrow, that is number, indicates the duration of a particular activity. So this excavation activity starts here and completes here. So how I told that this is an excavation, so whatever the things if I write above the arrow, so that is nothing but activity, description of that particular activity. So 2 units I require to complete that particular activity, which means I may require 2 days, or I may require 2 hours, or I may require 2 months, whatever it may be. Unit may be anything. So this is about the activity, how to draw activity. So if I write, this is the activity in the project, and if I write anything above the activity, that means description of that particular activity, which work is going on. So here it is excavation. So I have written here excavation. So in your, while drawing a network diagram, it may be curing or concreting. So likewise, whatever the description is there, so that I should write above the arrow, and whatever the duration I require to complete that particular activity, so that will be written below the arrow as shown. That is 2 units means 2 days or 2 months, whatever it may be. So depending upon your activity, you should write below the arrow, that is duration of a particular activity. So this is about the activity. So next comes the second fundamental which I require to draw a network diagram, that is event. So what event indicates? So event is the state that marks the completion of a preceding activity and the beginning of the succeeding one. So what it means, and here it has no duration, represents only a single point time. Symbolically, an event is shown by a circle or ellipse as follows. So what it means, event is nothing but, that is the state that marks the completion of a preceding activity. So as I told that in the previous class, so this is excavation. So this is excavation activity. So I require 2 days. So if I draw event here, symbolically event can be represented in circle format or in an elliptical format. So there is no hard and fast rule, that is I should use circle only or elliptical only. So depending upon your convenient for your project, you can use any symbol. So like you can see here 3 symbols, one is elliptical in this way, elliptical in another way, and in third one is circle. So in our project we are using circle type in order to look in a easy manner. So here if I draw an activity like this, which means, so this is an excavation activity. So I require 2 days to complete that excavation activity, which means if the arrowhead touches the circle, means, So this is event. So which means that is excavation of work is completed. If arrow touches the circle here, which means excavation of work is completed. So if event is drawn here means the excavation of work is started. So if I draw an event at the tail end of an arrow means it indicates start of an excavation of activity. If I draw the circle or the event at the head of an arrow means which indicates completion of excavation of activity. So this is about the event. Event means so either a particular work is starting or either a particular work is completing at a particular point. So that is nothing but an event which has no duration. As you can see in the case of activity, it has a duration. So excavation needs 2 days for the completion of an activity, but here there is no duration. It has no duration or zero duration because it is a state or some standard where a particular activity will end or a particular activity will start. So for that reason it will be having no duration. So the events are labeled numerically, that helps to identify them and describe the connecting activities. So you can see here, so for example event, which means one event, that is circle. So under that I have written one. So this is one event and this is another event. So this arrow, you can see here, arrow represents an activity. So for example take curing. So if I write curing, above the arrow means it is a curing activity. So I require 3 days for curing of a concrete. So if I write any number below the arrow means which indicates duration of that particular activity. So in how many days it will complete. So whatever the tail end is there, so you can say tail end you have one event or one circle. So that indicates curing of an activity is started. And the arrowhead, again you have one particular event, you can see here, that is number 2, which means after 3 days it has drawn. So it has come. So from that condition, curing of concrete is completed. So state of completion of a particular activity or state of starting of an activity is nothing but an event. So for that reason it will be having no duration. So as in the case of an activity. So this is about event. So just remember, so what is event, how to draw a particular event. So if I take, so we'll see with an example how to draw event, that is network diagram, by using event and activities. In that condition, if I solve one particular problem, we'll come to know that. So what is the meaning of event and activity and how they are utilized. So just remember, that is the event is represented in circle or elliptical format and it has no duration. An event means state of completion of a particular activity, as you can see in the tail end, or state of start of an activity as you can see in the event 1, or state of completion of activity as you can see in the event number 2. So this is about event. So next comes the third fundamental of network analysis, that is dummy activity. So what it means? Dummy means, as you can hear the word, that is dummy means which is used for a particular purpose. So it has no duration or nothing. So you can see here, it is superimposed activity which does not represent any specific operation or process. It has zero duration and consumes no resource. So what it means, as in the case of event or activity, it is not a particular specific operation or process. So it is just a superimposed activity. It just resembles an activity, but which has no duration, that is zero duration, and consumes no resource. So why it is used? So it has zero duration and also it requires zero resource for a particular dummy activity. Means why we need to use this particular activity. So its purpose is to provide logical link in order to maintain the correct relationship of activities and to simplify the description of concurrent activities in terms of event numbers. So it is shown or expressed in bottom lines. So just remember that dummy activity means, so it is drawn like a activity. You can see here, you can represent dummy activity in this format. First format, that is arrow, which is drawn in a dotted line. Dotted line arrow means it is a dummy activity. So one thing you remember, so dummy activity means arrow with a dotted line. And the second thing is it has zero duration and consumes no resource. So this is the second term you should remember. And the third thing is why it is used, in order to create a logic in the network diagram. So how to create logic in the network diagram? So what is the use of dummy activity? So we'll clearly see in the example. So in the here you just remember how we should draw, or how we can draw the dummy activity, that is arrow with the dotted line and it has no duration and also it consumes zero resource. So these are the two things just you remember about the dummy activity. So while solving problem, you will come to know the why it is used and how it is used in the network diagram. So these are the three main events which are very useful for drawing the network diagram in critical path method. And today we'll stop here itself and we'll continue further tomorrow. That is, we'll solve with one example. So how to draw a network diagram by using these events, so that the picture will be very clear. So what are the events, that is activity, event or dummy activity? So what are those? So how they are utilized while drawing the network diagram? So how to draw a network diagram logically? We'll see in the example in the next class. Thank you.